Imagine this. You wake up and you decide that your product deserves to be 50 meters tall. And instead of calling VFX Studio, you just open a free workflow. And boom. City of your choice, product of your choice, and beginner friendly, of course. And all this thanks to Weavy and new Nano Banana with sharp details and gorgeous generation quality. And I am giving you this workflow for free. But first, let me show you how it works. So this is how the workflow looks like. And what I did here are a couple of changes that makes this workflow even better than the previous one. The most important thing is that I used new Nano Banana, which is truly state-of-the-art model right now. And also I made the prompt easier to edit according to whatever you need. If you want your product to be placed in a certain city or at least style of a city, you can do that in here. And it's kind of a convenient because the new grouping feature, which I got early access to, is super cool. And now I will show you how it flows. So this is the main prompt here, which is locked because you don't need to change anything in here. And then we have a couple of nodes here, where here are some of locked parts that are not to be changed. And in here you can see I can place description of a city where I want the scene to happen, and maybe some additional features that should be there, maybe some famous building or whatever else. And together it creates one main prompt, and then you have your image as input. All those are plugged into Nano Banana, and with its new feature you can see that even texts are super sharp, and I actually don't need to change a single thing with such generation. And you can see also the size of the image is like night and day from what we got with the first version. And now, once you have your art ready and you are happy with the image, you can let it run 1, 2, 3 times until you find that one image that you actually like. There is one optional feature, because I wanted to branch it into portrait version and landscape version. However, with this image, the product is quite big, meaning that you cannot crop it easily, mostly for landscape version, because you don't have enough pixel by the sides. You can see that if I would plug this guy in, 16:9 wouldn't be good because the product would be cut. Therefore, I placed flux outpaint here, which will zoom out the image, and it will give you additional pixels all around. And then you can decide which one needs original generation and which one needs outpainted. In here, I used original for portrait version and outpainted for landscape. And now with those two images ready, I have two basic generations prepared, just as with the first one, where this generation is standard aerial orbiting view. You will plug whichever you want in here. And I'm using Seedense for that because it's reasonably priced and it's really good model. And now below that, there is a time-lapse version for which I'm using VO3. It's best for this job. And you only need to pick which one you want to plug into which. In here, you can see the scene is orbiting around. In here, the scene is zooming out. However, it's time-lapsed and daytime turns into nighttime. And I have prepared a couple of more options here because I have tested it with more images. You can see that I have like the black one in Paris. Should be somewhere upscaled in here. Yes. And now all those crop versions got updated, and also generation should be there. It's probably this one for orbiting. It also introduces orbiting of the product itself. I have one more in here. This is where the product is doing some interesting motions, but I could just easily let it generate one more time and it will be like glued to the building. And then there is a third one, green one, which is positioned in Singapore, I guess. And we can see same thing here. We have a white version. Then we have black can, which I like actually the most, because once it gets dark, that black and gold color actually like fits the scene really well. And of course, green one in Singapore. But to show you how it actually flows, I've prepared one more, because this is your image input. You will just click upload and upload your product. I will stick with the cans, and in here I will try to position it in Rome. Let's keep crossfalls tracking and digital signage there. That's fine, but let's add Colosseum. Not sure how it's spelled in English. I guess this is the case. If not, sorry. And now, as you can see, it got updated somewhere in here. Yeah, it's here. Colosseum and Rome is here. And with those two inputs in place, I can click run model and just wait. And while this is being generated, take a look also at those digital banners in here. They actually make sense. With previous version, they were just looking like from that brand, but it was probably too much. Now it actually cuts out some images, like the skull is here and also the name is correct. Murder Your Thirst. It's completely fine. So this way it is not one step forward, it's like at least 10. And now we are done. We have our image in City of Rome, which it definitely looks like it. It has digital signage here. There is a Foro Romano in the background, if I remember correctly. Here is Colosseum. Of course, it's not like a real city. It like samples it, but it looks like it. And I am completely fine with it. Now, I already can see that the portrait version would be fine. However, the landscape is not, because the product would be cropped. I will therefore let this guy zoom out, which should be generated pretty quickly. And actually, while this is being generated, I can plug vertical version. Let's say for this case, vertical version will be for the time lapse. And let's run the model. And now this is already zoomed out. I will use this as input in here and I will rescale it so it fits better. Actually, with this landscape version, it's way more suitable for this composition, because the Colosseum is actually seen much better. And I will plug this one as a first frame in Seedense, and I will let it create basic orbiting motion. And we have our generation done, which I already see it didn't turn out well. But I know exactly why, because I plugged in portrait version. However, with Veo 3, it does not automatically pick the aspect ratio, and I kept it set as 16:9. So I need to change it to 9:16, and we need to do it one more time. Run it anyway. And we have our landscape done, and it's pretty cool. Just as I told you, those banners are kind of readable, they have some logic. With video generation they got distorted a little bit over the generation, but with the image gen, super cool. And now we are done with the portrait as well. Ooh, this one is cool because when it gets dark, I can also see the stars, which I think wasn't the case with other ones, but you get the point. So this is it. You can use that workflow for free. It's in the description, and stay tuned for another one.